Gang, real quick before we get this episode started, summer is going into full swing, and so is the Are You Garbage Keep It Moving 2021 tour.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to be coming to a town near you for a little bit of stand-up, and we're going to be answering your garbage questions. Kippy, tell them what they need to know.
July 14th, Columbus Funny Bone. July 15th, Cleveland Hilarities. August 11th, Rhode Island Comedy Connection. August 12th, Laugh Boston. Those tickets are cooking. That's going to sell out. Get those tickets.
Hot one.
Then August 25th, we're at New Brunswick Stress Factory. And then August 26th, we're at Magoobie's Joke House in Timonial, Maryland, outside of Baltimore.
Okay? I like it, gang. Get some tickets. Come out and see. It's going to be a fantastic, fun time. A mix of stand-up comedy and the AYG game. Come out and hang with Uncle Hank and your Aunt Kippy.
Do it.
Welcome to another exciting edition of Are You Garbage? The show where you find out if your favorite comedians are classy individuals or absolute trash. Now, here are your hosts, Kevin Ryan and H. Foley.
I used to always get nervous when we'd go out to eat.
Okay.
The whole meal, I'd be worried that we weren't going to have enough to pay the bill. For some reason.
What?
Yeah, so real relaxed seven-year-old we got over here. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Did that affect your ordering at all? Not really, right? Like,
they'll figure it out. Everybody out there, and welcome back to everybody's favorite new podcast. This is
what a fucking liar this guy is. What a fucking liar.
He just threw you out from the left field.
I don't know if
field.
My family will be able to pay for all the food that I'm about to eat.
You shouldn't have had nine appetizers.
Exactly.
I wasn't hitting the fucking buffet or anything. I just had anxiety about it. Nobody asked me to chip in. I would have split a salad with somebody if it came down to it. Gang, welcome back to everybody's favorite new podcast. This is Are You Garbage?
Mm-hmm.
It's a little show. We sit down with your favorite comedians, and we find out if they grew up to be classy or if they're just a big old piece of trash. I'm your host, H. Foley, coming at you on a glorious day. We're down here at Aunt Tootie's basement. Mm-hmm. The whole neighborhood is abuzz.
Yeah.
Tootie's
star
has never
power.
Been this clean. She's been running around. She's all excited. I hope she didn't flash this guy when he was coming down the stairs.
Yeah.
She was looking forward to this. We couldn't be more excited. My co-host is coming at you from right next to me.
Mm-hmm.
He is the CEO of Are You Garbage?
Sure.
You're really an international businessman at this point.
Sure.
He's the head bozo around here. Show to get a little respect. Give it up for Mr. Kevin James Ryan.
Hey, gang. What's up? As always, please make sure you rate, view, subscribe on iTunes. Full video available on YouTube. And as you know, those numbers are...
True to roof.
YouTube's fucking cooking. And then the word on the street is that Patreon. Coming Woo! For that top spot. Big guys.
Got that
There's
big...
a new kid in town, baby. Coming for the king of New York. We're coming for him, all right? Patreon.com. Sign up. Get a bunch of fucking bonus content. It's cooking, baby.
Holy shit. How about a nice shout out to our producer extraordinaire, the magic man. He makes us all look good. We love him. You love him. T-Bone McMuffin. Toby McMullen.
Yeah.
What's up, dudes?
What up, T-Bone?
Nothing. Just fucking in that Hank carpool. Me and Uncle Hank listening to the oldies. This dude ain't never heard a song. Came out after 95. He's got the stereo juice. And we got Bruce over the bridge, bro.
News radio and an Egg McMuffin. That's all you're getting out of me. Don't be looking for conversation. I'm very disgruntled until I get my coffee.
You're reading the paper as you're driving. Did the Yanks win last night?
Bitching about the Mets. Gang, we're all giddy. We can't contain it because we could not be more excited to have our incredibly, incredibly special guest back with us today. We are so excited. He's currently on the infamous tour, which is selling the fuck out all over
it does
the country.
All right.
Host of Flagrant 2, creator, host, mind behind Schulz Saves America on Netflix. All right, we're talking about heavy hitters. We're talking about Bruce Wayne here.
Tony,
not the usual ding-dongs and deadbeats you see walking around this city. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the one, the only, Mr. Andrew Schulz.
Hey!
Schulzy!
What an intro. I love the intro, guys.
Thank you. Well, big man loves his intros.
We usually don't do big ones for returning. But we couldn't. I got to. I got to do it.
You're a special guest.
It's too fun.
Okay. I'll take it. What are we talking about, boys?
We were calling Foley fat, I think, at the beginning.
I wasn't saying fat.
I think that's where you left off, Andrew.
Because
he caught me with Schulz magic, Schulz logic.
I'm not saying that you're fat. What I'm saying is that you weren't really that concerned with whether they could pay the bill or not, to the point where you would sacrifice your order.
But yeah. I still had anxiety about it.
Sure.
Was right. I ordering two entrees? Yeah, but I felt bad about it, Schulze. I pulled my dad aside like, Pop, listen, I don't mean to do this thing.
But I need these mozzarella sticks.
But I'm getting the veal and the meatballs, all right?
Were they ever not able to pay? Was it ever like a weird...
No, never. No, never. Huh. Never. But I was aware of money, of like, you know, having it or not having it at a very young age.
Yeah.
That was shattered. I mean, we had a great childhood, don't get me wrong, but I was aware of it.
Interesting.
Yeah.
You didn't know that? You didn't see that in New York growing up in the fucking East Village? I'd be like, that guy has money, doesn't have money.
Your parents seem like they might have been a little more calm or a little bit more.
I don't know. Like, you know, my folks had a small business. And, like, my mom came from nothing. My dad came from more. So, but, yeah, it was weird. Like, I don't know. I never really had that idea if someone was poor or not probably until, or rich until maybe like high school, middle school really? Or something like that. Yeah.
Who was it? What'd you see?
There was a kid who wore these like Gap sweatsuits.
I don't know if this is
I don't know if that's
if
good
he's
or
rich
bad.
And poor.
Bro, no, this was the first time I knew someone was rich. I had a friend of mine.
Gap sweatsuits.
We might even have to like blank his name, but his name makes it that much better. His name was a Cagney.
Oh,
holy shit.
That kid's got a little bit of cash on him.
No kidding.
He was related to James Cagney.
What?
That was his uncle. Right?
Holy shit.
So we'd go over.
Did he walk around going, listen, see?
Bro, you'd think. He'd look the fucking part, hair combed to the side. It was everything.
What?
And it was amazing. And like, we would go to his house. It was right on fucking Central Park.
It was like Fifth Avenue shit.
It was like real bougie shit.
That's money up there.
Yeah.
Big time money, right? We're like, okay, you know, he's got money from the James Cagney estate or something like that. And years later, it turns out his father was a con artist.
Wow,
and he was
that.
Never even related to James Cagney.
Holy
shit.
Dude, that shit used to happen so much back in the day when you could just be like, I'm a Rockefeller.
Did the kid not know this?
The kid didn't know.
Did they take away his Gap sweatsuit?
Bro, they should have, but it was unbelievable, man. Like, I remember that.
Holy shit.
And then I thought back to, like, what was going on. He would say his dad worked for the CIA or some shit like that.
That's
like,
all. Oh,
he was in on it. Yeah. Come on.
He was being investigated by the FBI. But he thought that the guys were, like, working with his dad.
Oh,
so the way his parents would, I guess, tell him.
Yeah, we're working
like,
with
him. Yeah, we got a special case or something.
They're trying out the handcuffs on me today. Yeah. That's what they're doing.
Yeah, so it was
James, your dad's
nuts.
Actually a CIA astronaut.
Yeah, and he had fake cable. I remember that. That was the only suspicious thing.
What do you mean fake cable?
He had the box. I don't know if
like
you
the illegal, like the hot box.
Yeah, he had the hot box.
With the Spice Channel. Yeah, I remember that box.
Oh, dude, Spice.
Big fan of the box.
That's what sets an alarm off for New York kids if they got the box.
If they had the box, we thought it was so good. Dude, this is... I remember the
Cablevision or hit it.
My mom, so my mom's from Scotland, right? When she first made like some money, like you do, you know, like anybody, you kind of like flex a little bit, right? So
that's what this whole thing's about.
Just started 2 weeks ago.
Of course, right? So when she first made a couple bucks, she got like a mink coat, right?
My mom had a mink in the 80s.
Mink coat. I don't know if she's bought any new clothes since, but like she really had it. She got it. And then when we were living in this place, she got the full cable package. And I know she told Time Warner or whatever. I know she was just like, yo, everything.
Give me the, yeah.
Just
put the dish on the roof. I want everything. Exactly. Everything you can get, I want.
Everything. Because we had all the porn, right? And my mom wouldn't ask for that. But like it was like Playboy Channel, Spice. There was like three channels in a row.
Mm-hmm.
And me and my boys would go after school and we just watch porn together.
In my
apartment, mm-hmm. like in my room, we just watched porn.
That was a hot streak, those three channels, man.
It was great.
Yeah, it was
65,
great.
66, 67 for us. And
tattooed that on your palm.
Yeah, you'll never forget that run of channels.
Like the Manchurian Candidate, 65, 62, 67. We just heard him mumbling three numbers. His eyes were all aglaze.
But I remember.
Did she know or no that you were watching it or no?
She had no fucking clue. She didn't even know the porn was there. She
That's
just like,
insane.
Well,
give me the wide open.
She finds out because she saw us. Because the TV.
Everybody's walking out with fucking hard-ons.
Besides that. She's like, oh, they're kids. This is what you look like when you're a kid. So besides us all just having boners
being
together.
Glued to the couch for 8 months. No one's gone home. No one's went to school.
No one's eaten.
Their
nothing.
Parents are calling. Nobody will move. Yeah, she picked up on it.
No, she just saw it in the reflection of the window. And I had no clue, and literally it was gone like the next day. But there was like a 2-week streak where we were just
She didn't say anything to you?
Didn't say a single thing.
See, that's that's why.
That's respectable.
But that's why you never noticed people being poor or rich when you were a kid. Because there was no confrontation. She just took care of it.
Interesting.
That's interesting right there.
Yeah.
That's a different style of. My mom would have burst in. What are you doing?
Really?
You're going to hell. My God.
Really?
Buddy.
Because I would have got religion the no combo.
Or something or what?
I mean, yeah, they're just old school like that.
Yeah.
They don't go. I would have been out in the middle of the village square in one of those things. You kidding me?
But why? Because you guys were watching porn? Is that
Shame.
Bad?
Shame. Yeah, that's bad. Yeah.
It's Catholic
guilt.
Oh, okay.
It's a Catholic shame.
Yeah, I've never had any of that.
That's nuts.
Were you guys no religion growing
up? European.
No.
But it's also very Scottish of your mom to be like, we're never going to talk about this. Just.
That's true.
Remove the cable channels and just move forward like this never happened.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah. I don't know, but we would talk about stuff. We're pretty open. Like, I could say that to her. I could probably say at that time, like, Mom, did you switch the channels?
Then, what the fuck happened to 67, 68?
And then she would be like, you guys are watching some crazy shit. And then that would be it.
She hears a blood-curdling scream coming from the living room.
It's gone. Yeah, it's so weird, the shame thing, the guilt thing. I don't know. Yeah. I never felt that. Like,
and you know what's funny is I can't pinpoint it. Like, I can't pinpoint, like, you know, somebody sitting me down and saying, like, if you do this, it's bad.
Yeah.
But it's just there.
It's generations of that.
Still?
And then it's just instilled.
Like,
jerking off,
you feel bad?
I won't jerk off if somebody I know
me?
Is flying. I won't do it.
Wait, what?
What'd you say?
Yeah, like, if someone's in a plane, I won't do it.
What?
Why? I'll jerk off in a plane, dude. Crazy.
Yeah, I don't know. Why? Bad juju. I don't want to put it up there.
That's some old gypsy shit right there. Holy shit. God damn it, man.
Yeah. I don't want the pilot to go blind or something. God.
Who are you, Mickey from Snatch? What the fuck?
Bro. I just put together why you won't do it.
Why?
A lot of things were going through my like.
If he does
I'm
it,
still
something bad's gonna happen.
Yeah, if you do it, something bad happens.
But like the first,
I'm not gonna roll the dice with someone 30,000 feet in the air.
No, I get it. But listen, I'll be a little bit.
It's my cousin's wedding.
Yeah. I'm really hungover. But at first, I was like, what the fuck? Like, why would religion have anything to do with like people flying and jerking off? And then I'm like, wait, there was no flying back then. Like, I'm trying to like put together where this could.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, like, it's the shame. It's something bad. I'm going to be punished.
It's in the Old Testament.
Yeah.
Your Boeing nosedives.
No pulling at 2 hours before an international flight.
Yeah. That's crazy. So you think that God would kill your friend in a plane because you're jerking off?
I mean, I don't really think that in that
it's
rule.
It's not worth the risk.
I
believe in superstition. I'm superstitious.
I don't believe that now. I don't believe that now. But at a point when I was like younger,
you
I did.
Wouldn't.
I would just be like, well, I'll just wait till they land. Yeah. I had the flight tracker up.
You're
good. I had all the fucking dots on my TV.
Call them up.
Their wheels down.
Call them with the left hand. And everything all right, good.
Thank
See
God.
You later.
Shades just slowly come down.
I'll be home in 30. More than enough time.
Take your time.
Take your time. Grab me some Kahlua at the airport.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it's superstition. I mean, I don't think that now.
I don't see you guys going to church. Would you guys go to church?
There was periods where my parents would like make us. Yeah.
Growing up, every week.
Go on Sunday.
Every Sunday, you guys
get up.
Would go?
You go to mass on Sunday. You come back. You throw the Stooges on, and Dad makes a breakfast. That's how we did it.
Really?
Yeah, it was not bad.
I never really believed anything though. I was just like, hey, I'm standing here going through the motions.
But it's in there. Like, I didn't go at all to anything, but I still acted as if God existed.
100%.
Out of your own volition?
Yeah.
Especially for the bad stuff.
Because I kind of believe. I kind of believe in God.
Yeah. I'm agnostic. Yeah, I don't know where I fall.
I had your career. I believe in God, too, bro.
Yeah, what
Somebody's
the fuck?
Somebody's looking out for me.
Fucking Big Poppy over here.
But isn't that fucked up? Don't you hate when, like, successful people don't believe in God? It's like, you want all the credit?
Yeah.
Like, it's only you?
You just jacked a homer at Yankee Stadium.
I Is that crazy? Like, and then when these motherfuckers like Pedro Martinez believe in God, they're like, speed it up at the Epsies.
Yeah. That's a Manhattan speaking. Yeah. A couple old fashions.
But it's so like, yeah, come on. Like, of course they're going to believe in God. Like, imagine what they fucking came from.
Goddamn sure. Right. Yeah.
I mean, yeah. Imagine you're jacking homers in front of a fucking stadium.
It would take me 45 minutes to get around the bases. I'd be blessing myself so many times, yeah. Pointing up to the sky.
Yeah.
Every home run would be 2 hours waiting for me to get around.
Yeah, I don't know.
Crying my eyes out.
There's got to be something, right?
Of course.
There's got to be something. How do you write it off? Like, how do you write it off as nothing? There's got to be something. I didn't have to be like a guy with a white beard up there, like a wand and pointing
sure,
at shit, but
yeah,
there's got to
yeah,
be
yeah.
something. Like,
sure.
There's a formula built into this stuff. You know, like, you treat people kind of well. They want to treat you well. Things work out.
Are you a Scientologist?
Yeah,
what the fuck's going on?
What the fuck are you saying?
I'm telling you, bro.
It's 9 o'clock in the morning. I got half an Eddie in me.
There's a reason why half an Eddie.
The fuck's going? What'd you do in Miami, dude?
I want to ask you about what appetizers you ordered last night.
He comes
night.
Back with new shirts and shit, and spitting all this fucking God talk.
Like, what? He comes in Tom Cruise mode.
Eddie,
he's gonna have us hooked up to those electrodes and shit,
bro.
Telling our deepest secrets.
I can't get over that.
I don't know why, but I just gave Schulz all my banking information.
Eddie, bro, Ed is edible, right?
Eddie's edible.
Okay.
Poppin' Eddie.
I thought you were talking about like Ed and Eddie's or whatever.
No, Ed and Eddie. Shout out to Double D.
That?
It was a cartoon, Ed, and Eddie. It was
oh, no, I'm talking
bozo.
About the ice cream.
Oh, Eddie, Edie's.
Oh, Edie's.
Which Foley
like,
also does
half
a lot.
I Edie's in me. I was like, dude, before the podcast is 9 a.m.
It's cookies and cream.
It's fucking animal.
That's what my cardiologist recommended, a half a carton ice cream.
Hey, listen, don't
every
do the
morning.
Bro, that was science back in the day. No, my dad's doctor when he was a kid, he was skinny. He's like, you need a milkshake a day. He got it prescribed.
Yeah, jar of peanut butter.
Yeah. Jar of peanut butter.
Yeah, get at it.
They would prescribe calories.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
you're too skinny.
Time.
Eat 3 PB&J Sammies.
Yeah. Anyway, yeah, so God. Yeah, I don't know. I think there might be something.
This
I don't
kid
know
had a bacon
is.
Egg and Seroquel. What the fuck?
This guy's all fucking hopped up on goofballs.
Got fan base in the Midwest, goddammit. Talking about the heartland here.
We run a family show here, Schulz.
You're sending me to Columbus, Ohio in a week with this? They'll run us out of town on a rail.
By the way, Columbus and Cleveland. This might come out already.
No, you said something about your mom. That,
what was it?
That made me think of something. You said when she first got a little bit of cash, she bought herself something.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't think when you were on the last time, we got to that. Did you make any move like that? And this could be going back to guy code.
Like, anytime you got a couple of bucks, you're like, this is the first thing. I'm getting a TV, a fucking car.
Because you're very responsible.
No. Just recently.
Just recently what?
I started buying stupid things.
All right.
Like what?
Yeah, yeah.
Tell.
I bought a stupid watch when I was in Miami.
Ballpark. You want to write it down? That's what rich guys do. Rich guys do. Don't say the number. They write it down.
And slide it to me?
That's what you do.
No, it's like 21, 22.
What? Jesus.
Love that. I'm getting one of them.
All right, fuck it. Let's go. I hate it when people fake being humble about the things that they buy. I don't like it. So
that's
I bought the one.
That's what this
21,
show is, baby.
22.
22K.
Now it's 22. It went up.
No, now it's 44.
What? The watch?
So this what happened. Watches went crazy during the pandemic.
Of course.
Everybody
that.
Kept getting money. Like, here's the thing about happened about the pandemic and nobody really realized. Is like, did any of your favorite spots close?
No, not
did
really.
Did anything change?
Oh, here we go.
Nothing. Right? Like, literally, and this is fucked up to say, but like, the businesses that closed were the ones that were closing. Right? They were closing. And the ones that
they sound like Eddie Griffin.
They were already struggling.
Sure.
And then the ones that were doing well, they got the fucking PPP or whatever. They got the loans.
Yeah,
they
yeah.
were able to like kind of coast through it. And then they came back and they bought the shit that was next door and they just expanded.
Sure. So, a lot of people took this time to level up. Yeah.
Leveled up.
Yes.
You guys leveled up.
We leveled the
fuck
up.
You're talking
up.
To two cockroaches right now.
Just saying.
Survived the nuclear
so
holocaust.
Like,
how do you think I got commercial real estate
money.
In the middle in the fucking in fucking Manhattan?
You see a bathroom in here? That's commercial real estate, my friend.
There was a fucking plague and I took advantage. when there's blood
it.
In the streets, buy real estate.
You have to do it. So basically what happened is like people did okay, I think, during the pandemic and they got more money and then they were like, okay, so these rich motherfuckers, they got the loans, right? They got the PPP
yeah,
loans,
yeah, yeah.
Right?
And so now they got all this cash, and like, where do I put in something before it dips? Because sure. inflation is going to come. People bought the watches. Like, watches doubled.
Did you know this when you bought the watch?
So I got an AP, right? Do you guys know? It's like a fucking whatever. It doesn't matter. I'm no fucking watch guy.
AP is
like,
a company?
Yeah. So basically, there's a few of these watch companies.
But it was talking about like an accountant or something.
Are AP watches nice?
So like, so basically, this is the whole thing with the watch shit is they know exactly what they're doing. They limit the inventory like crazy. You know, it's like with girls with bags in the same way. So in order to get that watch, usually you got to wait for 5 years. And maybe they offer you a shittier one and you just got to buy it, hoping that they'll offer you the one you want.
How are you making these? Are you going into the store?
No, I walked in the store with my girl and then the girl knew me in the store. And then we walked in, and I don't know anything even about the watch. I'm a complete fraud with the watches, right?
You got a coffee in your hand? Nice day in Miami?
No, I have the website for the store in my hand trying to get the name of the watch.
Ah, this guy stinks.
It's called a Royal Oak, right?
Should have a glass of champagne in your hand, you walk
Oh, they
in.
Offer the everything to you. It's amazing, yeah, the whole deal, right?
Do. Yo, so, this is the fucking straight James Bond joint I'm looking at right
now. It's a nice watch. It's a nice watch.
It's
a nice watch. You know what I mean?
That's the go-go big, gadget,
that's a,
John?
That's a big boy. I mean, like, look.
It comes with a death.
No. Guys. This is just the sub. This is just a little rolly. You know what I mean? It's something light.
You got
it's something
balls
light, bro.
To come to tooties with a rolly on?
Listen, it's just a little something light, bro. It's just a little something light. You know what
I
mean?
I don't think
but
I've
you
want to
know something really trash? You
I don't
know
think I've ever heard of a Rolex.
This is something. This is actually. This is called a Rolex Submariner. This is how fucking. This is how fake I am in terms of watches. Damn. I asked the guy if I could, as one of my boys, Miles, who edited the pictures and stuff for the special, the Netflix special. I go. We're about to shoot something in Miami. I was like, bro, I'm on a jet ski. And I was like, can I get this thing wet? And this is a guy who like works for me. He's like 26 years old and like he has to kind of respect me.
Yeah.
And in that moment, he just lost all respect. And he goes, it's called a Submariner.
Yeah, it's underwater.
Like, underwater is in the name of the fucking watch.
Hey, man, what kind of batteries
just
is
just get on the jet ski, you know? So
my last watch was a shark watch, and that was waterproof. So I assume this one's also waterproof.
I think I'm going to change the band. I'm not sure.
So look, this
you
is.
You don't have to know.
Is this
about
trash?
That,
is this trash?
I mean, the fact you were wave running with a Rolex is trash.
That's
great.
I bought my. So I bought it for my girl. My girl really wanted it, right? Mm-hmm.
That one?
This one. She really wanted it. It's
you a
guy's
a girl's watch?
It's a guy's watch, but she's trying to be like.
That's pretty cool.
But that's next level when girls wear like guy shit.
Yeah, she's pretty fashionable.
She's a cool girl.
So look, so this is what happens. We buy the, and I'm looking at this watch, and I'm like, I really like this fucking watch. And I bought this girl, right? And I find out, because it's a diving watch, they create this thing where this is how she wears it, right?
Okay.
So it's a diving watch. You have to wear it over your wetsuit. So they build in this thing where you could extend it and stretch it out. So I basically am like, well, this could be both of our watches.
Yeah.
So I found a way to buy her a watch that
and
I
and you
wear.
Also get a Rolex.
Now, what is that?
That's trash.
That's a
garbage.
Different level, though. That's a different level. Wow. That's trash?
Yeah, you're sharing a Rolex with your girl, and you got money.
Let's go! Did I find a way to be really
connected to your
successful
new,
trash?
You're new money, dude. You are the fucking definition.
I'm the epitome of new money.
I got a Rolex, but I rent it.
100%. Dude, rented a G-Wagon down there in Miami.
Yes! Listen, we're laying down the line. Schulze just changed the fucking game. When famous people come in, I want to see their watches.
Oh, yeah.
Next time I bring the AP, guys. Ooh. You know what I mean? Next time I bring the AP.
Gang, Helix Sleep, Helix Sleep. Let's talk about Helix Sleep. Let's talk about getting a good night's sleep.
Mm-hmm.
Mucho importante.
Be important, as the kids would say.
You got to do it. And as you get older, the way the world is, it gets a little bit harder to sleep. You toss and turn. You need a nice, comfortable mattress.
Mm-hmm.
And the folks at Helix can straighten you out.
Yeah. They even got mattresses for the big man.
They got some plus sizes.
They got them for the play. Got them for everybody, guys. This is Helix has a quick little quiz you take. It takes 2 minutes to complete and matches your body type and sleep preferences with the mattress that works for you.
Mm-hmm.
Why would you sleep in a mattress that's designed for somebody else?
What are you, Bozo?
What sense does that make? Walking around, you got enough of going on in this world. You gotta be able to a good night's sleep.
Smarten up.
Me and my wife took the Helix quiz, and we were matched with the Twilight, and I gotta tell you, this is my first nice good mattress for
it's
me.
Nice.
I didn't know what I was missing.
Yeah.
It's fantastic. You get a good night's sleep. My lady loves it. Easy peasy. Ships to the house. Forget about it.
When you get a good night's sleep, man, and you realize you're in a good mattress, that is a game changer.
Well, I had a queen my whole life. I always just had queens that have been, like, passed down to me from, like, you know, an old friend or an aunt or an uncle or something.
Sure.
And now it's the first mattress I bought on my own. top notch. And I go, I didn't know what, you don't know what you're missing. I might upgrade to a king. There That's go. How good my night's sleep bar I'm going. I didn't know what I was missing out on.
This kid's talking crazy.
So if you're looking for a mattress, you take the quiz, you order the mattress, it gets matched to you, comes right to your door, ship free. You don't ever have to go to the mattress store again. And also, who wants to be sleeping on other people's mattresses, testing out mattress, laying down? Pandemic, what are we doing?
Order it right to the door.
Right to the door. They were awarded number one best overall mattress pick of 2020 by GQ and Wired magazine.
Nice.
Let's go. Just go to helixsleep.com/garbage, take the 2-minute sleep quiz, and they'll match you with a customized mattress that'll give you the best sleep of your life, big guy.
Fantastic.
10-year warranty. You get to try it for free for 100 nights, risk-free. They'll even pick it up if you don't love it, but you will.
Nice.
Helix is offering up to $200 off all mattresses, up to $200 off all mattresses, and 2 free pillows for our listeners at helixsleep.com/garbage. One more time, that's helixsleep.com/garbage for up to $200 off and 2 free pillows.
You got me. I'm sold. Take my money. Kid B, I got a little tip for you.
What's that?
Caliper CBD, baby. Not too shabby.
Nope.
Absolutely fantastic. Mm-hmm. I'm a big CBD guy, sure. As you know.
Of course.
We got the caliper. We got the powder.
Ooh.
Unbelievable.
Clean living.
Takes away the stress, the pain, the soreness.
Yeah.
You want to sleep a little bit better. Good stuff mixed right in. Top notch. Fantastic. I love it.
Yeah, guys. I'm a big CBD guy as well. It kind of just helps me keep a little more all around calmer. You know, I'm more calm when I'm taking it.
Of course.
And Caliper CBD is a powder that is the only clinically proven fast acting CBD. That's what they got. Clinically proven fast-acting CBD.
I like it. I love the powder. I love the idea of the powder.
Yes, because it's a powder, it's 30 times more CBD in the first 30 minutes versus the oil. I used to be an oil guy. I'm now a powder guy. Okay? You get all the benefits of CBD in just 10 minutes. Some oils and other things can take up to an hour to absorb. Not with Caliper CBD. It's precisely 20 milligrams in each packet. Always THC-free. Feel better without the high. No weird taste. No residue in the mouth.
Mixes nice.
Mixes easily in any food, drink, yeah. Whatever you got.
That's water. Why I like it.
Put it in soda. You put it in whatever you want to do. It's all natural, vegan, non-GMO, free of fillers. No added chemicals. No artificial flavors. None of that jazz. Just the good stuff.
They do it right.
So you get 20% off your first order when you use promo code GARBAGE at trycaliper.com/garbage. One more time, you get 20% off your first order when you use promo code GARBAGE at trycaliper.com/garbage. The link will be in here. You can try Caliper CBD risk-free for 30 days. If you don't love it, they'll give you a full refund.
And you got to try it, especially if it's your first time with CBD. What a great intro.
Sure.
You know what I mean?
Of course.
Powder, mixed in some water, drink, whatever. Boom, bang.
Yeah, trycaliber.com/garbage. Don't forget promo code GARBAGE for 20% off your first order.
All right, okay. So you got that.
So I got the AP.
Is this all in Miami? Miami.
Miami got to you, dude. Miami you were in Miami me. For 48 hours. You posted a video of you in the back of like a Maybach or something. You had a golden AK-47.
Golden AK-47.
Dirt bikes around
the
you.
The Testarossa. We were driving a Testarossa. It was big. It was big. Man. I was looking into Ferraris when I was down
there. Did you buy a car?
I bought a car.
What'd you get?
This is the most trash. You ready? You're not even ready. You're not even ready for how fucking trash this is.
Believe me.
I bought a 1957.
Oh, it's class.
Porsche 356.
What?
Right? Yeah, this is a speedster. It's the most beautiful car ever made. That or like the Jaguar XK. But
Down in Miami for maybe 6 months.
No,
you're
they're building
house.
It for me now.
Oh my God.
What?
Because it's class.
Who got their hooks on you?
No. Because it's a fake Porsche.
What?
It's the body kit. You're doing
a kit.
He's doing a kit.
I'm doing a replica.
You're building models. Come on,
dude. Even at least my key is real. Jesus Christ.
Is it?
I think so.
Is it though?
I mean,
wait, why?
What makes it real?
Why are you?
This is a guy who just bought a fake Porsche.
This is
trying to make that fucking
exactly right. Like, what makes it? Bitcoin is.
Yeah.
Okay. This is my thinking. I'm looking into all these old cars, right? I was looking to get in the
car. So you're down there, you're saying, hey, I want to buy a car.
I
want a Ferrari.
Cast up
you
in said Miami.
I want a Ferrari.
You think in your head you want a Ferrari.
I want a
what
Ferrari.
Do you do from there?
I'll tell you why I want a Ferrari. There's something
in
different
York,
with a
though?
Ferrari. No. Well, back then when we were down there, I was like, I don't know if I'm going to spend, 7 months a year. Like, I was still figuring things out, right? Mm-hmm. New York was still, like, disaster sure. zone, and, like, we weren't exactly sure. And I wanted something to take the top down in. You know what I mean? It's nice days. It's good weather. You want
I mean,
the
guy's got good fucking
down.
Points.
Toby.
You know what I mean? You want to see the sun. You want to feel it on your shoulders.
I love
you're in Miami.
Feel it on your shoulders. So I'm like, let me look into this. And I start looking into these, like, I don't really care for the new cars that much.
But I like the old cars, and the old cars are really beautiful because back then they didn't give a fuck about anything. Mm-hmm. Now you got to like create a car based on all these like gas requirements.
Sure.
So building the cars is really difficult for the designers, mm-hmm. right?
It's restricted to all the regulations.
Exactly. Yeah, yeah. So you got
back then it was wide open. Son, it was whatever was best for the car.
Whatever was beautiful.
Oh, they could shoot babies out the back. It didn't matter.
Literally, yeah. Yes. And here's the other crazy thing. They were building rocket ships at the same time. Like the golden age for cars yeah. is the golden age for like space exploration. So everybody making a car was like, I want to make a rocket ship.
Yeah.
And the people driving were like, I want to drive a rocket ship. Right? I mean, what the fuck did they give? They gave a Corvette to every like Nassau dude. NASA. Yeah, NASA. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Nassau.
Nassau. Some dirtbag on perks. Every dude in Nassau County had a Corvette, 1963.
So they gave it, and that was like the brilliant branding, right? Because who doesn't want to be a fucking astronaut, especially back then?
Sure. The sunglasses, the tight haircut, everything.
Beautiful.
Chuck Yeager.
Astronauts fell off, bro.
Yeah, they were used to be like cowboys, now they're nerds.
All
yeah.
test pilots and stuff like that.
But they were beautiful. They were like handsome and
yeah.
shit.
They were like Maverick. Like, they were like Top Gun. They were like, I'm a fucking cowboy, let's go.
All Absolutely. The right stuff. Hot Tom chance. Wolf.
You're
Great
right.
book.
Yeah, yeah.
Didn't read it.
Better movie. Didn't okay. read the book.
I'll check out both. But yeah, so I'm looking at these cars from back in the day. And I'm like, okay, maybe I'll get that. And then I start looking into these Ferraris. And I'm like, wait, you can get a Ferrari for $60,000?
Kit car.
No.
Straight
you get a
up.
Real old Ferrari for $60,000.
Okay.
Between like 60 and 80, like a nice.
Are you going old, around down to Miami to different showrooms and shit?
A couple times I went to showrooms, right? But like, I'm just looking for things, right? And I'm like, okay, let me do this. And then I start talking to my boys, and they're like this. They said this about the Ferrari. Here's the thing about Ferrari, why it's different than anything else. You buy any other sports car than a Ferrari, people hate you when you drive. They hate you. You drive around a McLaren, they're like, who's this fucking asshole in a McLaren?
Sure.
You drive a red Ferrari for whatever reason. People root for you.
Yeah.
There's something aspirational about the red
it's
Ferrari.
It's the epitome, right?
I can't speak.
Magnum P.I., baby.
Dude, there's something about it. You see it, and you're just like, holy
that
shit.
That guy got it. He achieved it. He unlocked. He beat the boss. He's there. He beat the game.
It's like, because everyone's like, you're a dickhead, but you know it.
Yeah.
That's it.
There's no hiding behind
it. You leaned
in.
Yeah. You're like, and also at the same time, it's like, you want it.
Of course.
I don't want a fucking McLaren. I don't want these other cars. I don't even care Rolls Royce, none of that other shit. But the red Ferrari, you're like, oh my God, I would love to be driving that fucking car.
That's so true. Wow. So,
I don't know why we root for it, but we root for it. It's amazing.
Pair
branding.
Of shades on.
That's
zipping
it.
Down the highway.
Hot broad That's on it. Your arm.
Exactly. How can you hate that man?
You can't.
How can you hate him?
You
if
can't.
It's any other
Little
sports
D
car,
Martin
fuck
playing
him.
As they zip by. Fucking class. Huh.
Class.
That's so true.
So I'm looking into that, and then I find that every one of these old cars, you're in the shop every week. Okay. Every week. So basically, the way they told me to get the car is like, dude, don't even buy the car. Don't even buy the car from the person. Mm-hmm. Go to the shop that you're going to have it fixed at and see if they know anybody selling, because that's the most important relationship you're going to have.
Right.
Because you're going to have to bring the fucking car
in. There. Yeah.
So I go, I don't want to deal with this every single fucking week.
Uh-huh.
You don't got to bring your key in.
Nope.
Ever.
If I do, they take care of it.
Done. So I start looking. I look at this Porsche, the Speedster, the real one, and I'm like, I'm not going to spend $400,000 on a car because that's what they cost.
Mm-hmm.
And then I start looking at these $400,000 Speedsters. Maybe, maybe not.
Playing that one close.
Could I buy
yeah.
one? Could I buy a Speedster? Multiple.
You want a Speedster? You got a Speedster.
I'll be honest with you.
I'll get T-Bone a Speedster.
I'm glad you broke that because I got real nervous when you were like, man, man.
No. So I'm looking at it. I'm like, okay, so you buy a $500,000 car. And because it's authentic and real.
Sure.
Right?
Yeah.
And then you replace the tires. Then you replace the rims.
How
you
real is it?
Keep going on that.
Yeah.
Keep. What are you
gotta
paying for?
Gotta redo the
for?
Engine.
What you, I'm not paying.
I need a new quarter pan.
So
though.
I could tell you two mooks that I got the real fucking Porsche?
Yeah, we're not looking for responsible purchases here.
Fuck that.
No, I get it. But
so
the only
what
thing.
What did you exactly get?
So basically they build the car. Right?
Uh-huh.
They take the, it's a company called Vintage Speedster. They've been doing it for a while. They're great guys. And I went out to, when I was in Phoenix doing shows, we went out there and like drove the cars and shit like that. And basically what they do is they take an old
So this is a multi-state purchase.
Yeah, 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 yeah. You guys will be the first ones to ride in it.
Yeah.
Dude, 100%. That's content right there, baby.
I'm driving up to the studio. I'm driving up to the commercial real estate.
Commercial real estate, ladies
and gentlemen.
You
got to use the bathroom. You need a key. That's how you know you got an office.
It's shared with everybody else on the floor, but there's never.
We got two cabinets in the kitchen. Come see me.
I love it. But yeah, so I'll come up, and basically what they do is they take an old VW bug. What is it called?
Chassis.
Card. Chassis, is that it? And then they chop it down, right? And I got my license at 21 years old. I don't know anything about cars.
Sure.
I'm from the city. So they chop it down to the size of the Speedster, and the Speedster, like the shell of the Speedster, the shape was never copywritten by Porsche.
So it's why anybody can make it. Yeah.
So then you basically, I'll pick your color, pick all the things that you want to do, and then they build the engine from scratch, so it is the same engine as a Porsche.
A
lot of people put like a Subaru engine or that kind of shit, but this guy's like, no, I want to build you the engine from the car.
Yeah.
So I'm like, yeah, do everything that is the
car. Yeah.
I don't give a fuck about cars. Sure. I just think it looks pretty.
Exactly. If that's all you're worried about, then yeah, that's the play.
It's crazy that is very you, that you came to that.
What is that?
Your reasoning for all that. How did you meet these people where you could?
I'm not trying to impress these rich fucks.
Yeah, but he'll impress us.
Exactly.
Yeah. I'm impressed either way.
He impresses the guy on the street. He doesn't impress the car nut. The car nut goes, "That's a fucking replica car. That's new money. Get this fucking bozo podcaster out of here,
bro."
I look at it and go, "Damn, Schulz has got a little bit of cash." There we go. It's a win-win. He saves fucking $250K.
Dude, it's 50. It's 50 grand.
You think I'm breaking out
the whole thing?
On you guys?
The whole thing's 50.
50 grand, bro.
All right, I got a very important question.
Go. Yeah.
You see Jerry outside of a club.
I can't wait.
He's going to spit on the hood of that thing.
I can't wait for us both to be driving our Speedsters and his just sputters out in the middle of Fifth Avenue. I just pass him.
Talk
you
to my guy down in Boca, Jerry.
Sounds like you got some old parts there, Seinfeld. That bucket of bolts you're knocking around in. I got a brand new one. Chassis from Phoenix. Engines from Seattle.
But this is what they're doing. So
I give you a lift, but I told this fat kid I'd take him for a ride. Tough break, big guy.
So my boy Jason, I love him. I love him to death. He's fucking amazing. Jason Levine, he's an absolutely amazing guy. From Long Island. He is like Gatsby. But you know how like Gatsby was a bootlegger?
Yeah.
Like, tricked everybody in thinking he wasn't? That's what Jason is. So Jason's in the Hamptons, but he'll find every little truffle and hustle that he can to make shit work. You know what I mean? Like, he'll get the nicest house on the other side of the street that's not as desirable, but he's still in the
sure,
neighborhood
yeah,
type
yeah,
of thing.
Yeah.
Like, he's a
genius.
We were
just talking about that.
He's a master with the shit. And so what he's realized is in the Hamptons, the new money motherfuckers get the shiny car. This is what the rich, rich people do now.
Yeah.
They get the old car. Jerry does this. They get the old car and don't change anything. Mm-hmm. They want the scratches.
The
they
original.
Want to be
sure, an old Beamer. Baldwin talked about that. That he has like a beat up car that he
the
has.
Bomber.
Yeah, the bomber that he has out at the Hamptons house.
Yep.
It's like they want the rips in the seat.
They want the fucking rips. But isn't this crazy? Like, they have the ability to not have them, but they have
that's
to
classy,
find
though.
A way to that's level up on rich people. They're like, oh, you're rich and you have rich things?
Yeah.
Why would you have rich things as a rich person?
Well, it's the only way they can feel. They've driven all the shiny, fancy cars with the fucking, you know, the leather and this and the that. They've done that. They've been doing that for 20 years.
Yeah.
Now they're going, I haven't driven in a car with a rip seat and fucking since I was poor.
Yeah.
Let's go back to that.
Yeah, everybody is trying to get over, I think, in that regard. But I think it's also like everybody's craving authenticity. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like everything's so fake right now.
Mm-hmm.
Like that's what
like
kids
your
are
car.
Looking for. Like super fake. For real. 100%. No, 100%. Sure. Like it's so.
Let me see that Rolex again.
No, dude, think about it.
Fucking, that was a little light, if you ask me.
This fucking thing's got two E's on it. What's the deal? There's no nine.
But isn't.
Schulz just got a Rolex with no nine.
There's no nine. Everybody knows Submariners don't have threes on them.
But isn't
Schulz, what time is it? I'll tell you in an hour.
Isn't that the issue? Is like it's so easy to fake everything.
Sure, it is.
It's so
sure,
easy
it is.
To be skinny on Instagram. It's so easy to get a fucking fake Porsche. Like,
it is, of course.
So now people are going to be drawn to the authentic thing.
I like
got
that.
Chips in it.
I like that.
Yeah.
I like that.
Mm-hmm. It's very fucking true. Yeah.
Why do you think your show's successful?
Yeah, because we followed what you did.
No, you guys are talented and funny, but you're also sitting here going, "This is our authentic self."
This is well that
it's
like
so easy to lie.
You've talked about that in so many podcasts and whatever, and that I've listened to when you really started buzzing a few years ago. And it was like, just be authentic and, you know, the rest will fall into place.
Yeah, like, there's people like you.
And we never, it was so funny because we, like we said, we used to play this game ourselves. And we're like, the thing that made us popular was the thing that we would just do at 3 a.m. driving home from like Altoona, Pennsylvania. And it's like, that's insane. Because that's the real genuine thing.
This is what we want to do. What you're telling us right now. Yeah. I'm just like fucking, it's like Saturday also, morning cartoon.
And it works. It's great. It's fucking amazing. I remember the first time I saw you guys doing it. I was like, yeah, this is it. Yeah. This is fucking it.
Appreciate that.
But
can I ask you this?
Yeah, go.
I know we talked about the car and stuff like this, but this is.
Ooh, I want to say one more thing about the car. And just in general, like, isn't it just the perfect encapsulation of like what everything is happening? Not only right now, but like with me, but just with everybody. It's like there's a hack. There's a way around anything.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like to get the watch. Like, I don't care about watches. But if you're going to get me one and it doubles in value when I walk out of the store, I'm going to fucking do it.
Yeah.
You know, I don't give a fuck about the watch. But I need to tell you that. If I walk around here masquerading like I care, that's fraudulent.
That's fraudulent. Yeah,
if I get a fake Porsche and the back license plate says fake Porsche.
If you own it.
Is it going to say fake Porsche?
Maybe FKEPRS.
Yeah, if you were going, if you say like
this guy, fucking guy can't spell. He's got a fake Rolex.
How'd this guy get a fake Porsche? I don't know. No, yeah. If you didn't say anything, if you tried to stand on airs, I get it.
People are so afraid.
But I also think
man.
You're trying to save $300,000.
Yes.
Yeah. Who is it?
Yeah.
Because the car doesn't mean anything
to me.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying to you.
It doesn't mean have like there are people who really care about that shit and like. That's fine. I respect that. That's what you really care about. We have comedy we really care about.
Sure, of
Most
course.
People don't give a fuck. If we just did accents, they'd die laughing.
Exactly. But we're like, you know, we're.
We care about this.
The art, this. That,
what
yeah, exactly.
do you material wise care about having authentication?
You know
for?
What's weird?
What like, are you spoiling yourself on?
I don't even spoil myself on it, but like.
I know you I like a nice dinner.
Oh, okay.
You just started. That's new.
That's
you
new.
Like a nice
sneakers.
Dinner.
I like. Sneakers, I like. But I'm not even spending that much money on sneakers. But sneakers probably will be hard for me to buy fakes. But then again, I've seen people with fake Jordans.
Mm-hmm.
They're the same thing.
Oh, my God.
Bro, they're the same thing, dude. And it's unbelievable. Listen, it's unbelievable what you can get right now. They got a factory right down the block from the factory that makes the real Jordans.
Yeah.
The same workers. They're going from that
yeah,
one to
yeah,
that
yeah,
one.
Yeah, it's the night
guy,
shift.
Everything is there.
Mm-hmm.
And they have all these
all
communities
the materials
and
are sourced there. Everything.
Bro, we're old, so we don't understand. But like everything that's happening right now, like on Reddit, like literally you just find a guy. He barely speaks any English. You go, you got these in a size 13, whatever. They're like, yeah, I can get you size 13. They send it. Maybe it's a color you want. Maybe it's not. But it's like you either spend $2,000 at Flight Club mm-hmm. or you spend $50.
What's I don't know the difference. If you're walking by me, I go, that guy's got a nice pair of Jordans.
Bro, it's unbelievable.
Hmm.
It's unbelievable. So that's what's going to happen. And then there's going to be a flip, and then people will find a way to, like, authenticate things.
Yeah. I want the old ones with mud that were original from 1983.
That will definitely get – that will definitely start popping.
Yeah.
Is there a God and what is real? Andrew Schulz, ladies and gentlemen, coming in. Have you
– Yeah.
I'm not saying shopped. I'm not saying, you know – putting the kind of research in that you did with the car or anything like that.
Yeah.
But by chance, have you poked around? You're sitting on the couch one night. You're thumbing through the phone.
I think I know where this is going.
Yeah.
Have you taken a peek at a plane? Do you have any?
Or even like NetJets
plans
or something.
For that?
I think
where do you see? Because, you know, because.
The plane's too expensive.
Plane's too.
But.
Off the table, foreseeable future? Is that somewhere you want to end up?
It's so expensive. I want to do the plane for the tour.
Okay.
Yeah.
I want to do the plane for the tour. So what I want to do is like, if you want a private jet from like New York to California, you're looking at like, what is it? 50 to 70 G's
it's
or
a
something
lot,
like
yeah.
that. It's too much money.
You can like dead. You can like deadhead it where you're like, they're already flying out there so you can get on for cheaper.
Yeah, but I don't want
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I know. I'm just saying, but like you can
then
get
you
it.
Then you can't listen to your music. You
sure,
know what I mean?
Yeah.
You got like some other
it's like an Uber.
There.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah,
you're doing
you're
Uber.
There with a
oh, what
couple
the
other
fuck?
Closer.
They got that?
Yeah.
I'm not sitting next
well,
to
the
other rich people.
Well, the plane's got to go to L.A., so they're like, we can sell the fucking tickets
yeah.
on the seat. You know,
yeah,
so
come
like,
on.
You
what
get there
we
for $3,000 or something.
I'm not so sharing my sushi.
The hustle that we'll do is, and I've already figured out the hustle.
Build a fake plane?
No.
Because I already started looking at planes, to be honest
so
with you.
So I got to fly. When I'm traveling, I got to fly like six people, right? So it's like. You look at how much that ticket costs
of
for
course.
Six people, right?
I do it with three, yeah.
Boom. So I'm looking at this, and I'm like, all right, it's six of us going here, and let's say we have to go from Austin to Dallas or Dallas to Houston.
you know, or Tucson to L.A.
Mm-hmm.
If that flight's 7,500, right?
Are you flying first class?
I fly first class, yeah.
Just you?
Yeah.
Power moves.
Yeah.
I'm writing that down.
I mean, listen.
Would you say that's behind you?
Someone greases the wheels on this machine. You know what I mean? No.
Would you say those days are behind you?
What's that?
At the very least.
You can't fly coach.
Yeah, I'm going to fly coach on the way back from the gig.
This guy stinks.
From Denver.
He likes to keep his foot in the water, man.
There was no tickets left.
All right, that makes sense.
I don't care about, the only thing I care about.
He likes to be on the streets.
Exactly.
Keep his finger
man
on
of the
pulse.
People.
No, it's
see what's
it's a,
going on.
It
on
is
TikTok.
It is a little bit more money, but it is so much more comfortable. It's unbelievable. It's not even flying.
Every time we fly, we are literally in the last row in the plane. Our seats don't go back. It's me, Foley, then Toby,
and two seatbelt extenders.
No, but you're gonna get enough miles, so they'll start bumping you up. Like, that shit drives me crazy because my boy Alex Media is my Toby. Right? And Alex. Has so many flight miles that he'll get bumped up to first class, and it fucking drives me
crazy. And you buy the ticket.
Yeah.
Yeah, because you can't, you're not going to roll the dice to see if you... Awesome.
Coach, and he's bumped up, and I'm sitting next to... the whole reason I'm here...
Yeah, that's annoying.
...is so I can feel better than all of you.
Of course.
I don't like this bump up.
Yeah.
What's going on here?
What? I want a buddy up there. Are you kidding me?
No. Thanks, no, you don't. You don't want to talk to anybody when you're up there. It's absolutely amazing. But no, so the PJ thing, I was looking into the PJ thing, and so I think it makes sense for those short flights. So it's a little bit more, but it's so much cooler, and you create this kind of funky stuff where you put Instagram, and you just create this world.
Of course, yeah.
And for a little bit more money, you create this world and have tons of comfort, and then all the guys are flying on a private jet. That's super exciting for them, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But it's too
expensive.
We're trash. That's why we're asking you.
Of course.
To go to L.A. is too crazy, but if you're doing... Chicago to Milwaukee, any flight that's an hour, and you're already going to have to spend. Yeah, if you're already going to have to spend.
A couple of grand. Yeah.
That's so funny.
Would you ever do a bus?
Nah. I mean, maybe, but I'm not against it, but nah, that's not that comfy.
We're talking private jets here. Yachts, caviar. No one's taking a bus.
We're talking hour-long private jets. I think we can bring up buses.
Yeah. It's fake Porsche, okay? 40-minute private jet.
Fucking puddle jumpers. Bro, and this PJ stands for puddle jumper.
This is how trash we are, right?
Balling from St. Paul to Minneapolis.
We would do it with two layovers. I would do it. And this is how much we want to fake it, right? Is we have a guy who's got this company called Wheels Up that we were talking to, right? And he was, was talking to us. Maybe we work something out. And he offered.
I like how the guys with the companies are starting to pop up.
Oh yeah,
it's like
that's the best. And then you realize how real money works, and this whole thing is completely. Yeah, it's
talking to this guy.
Everybody makes money before we even think it exists. Put it that way. There's so many levels.
I love people. There's private jet people hitting him up. I got hit up the other day by a guy. I'm trying to start a screen printing company. Can I print you T-shirts? I go, yeah, man. Our guy stinks. He goes, all right, I need a $200 deposit. I'm like, what the fuck? I don't even know you. Now I'm cash apping this dude $200.
And we are currently in business together. he closed the sale on Kippy.
Anyway, there's these two planes, right? I forget the names of them, but there's levels to even the private jet
of
shit.
Of course.
Oh, you have what is that? Lear is this.
Sure.
It's all this fucking mumble.
Lear's nice.
It's bullshit. But there was one that he was suggesting, and then Dove, the guy that's running
your boy,
things,
yeah.
And he was
he managed the day-to-day business manager?
I'm basically grooming him to be my manager.
Gotcha.
But he's part of everything. Mm-hmm. So he's just a brilliant guy.
We met him when we did Flagrant.
Yeah. Good guy.
He's a great guy. And so he was like, there might be eight people. He's like, oh, okay. So for 8 to 10, we would recommend this one, right? And the other private jet had propellers.
Nope.
So I had to tell I had to tell the wife she can't come on the trip.
What do you
can't fly with propellers? Yeah. You know what I mean?
Unless you're doing
what are we, the Cleveland Indians? What's going on here?
Unless you're doing a blitzkrieg in fucking Dusseldorf, you can't have propellers.
It's ain't major league here.
You're blitzkrieging yourself.
Yeah. Fucking kamikaze that thing.
So yeah, it was. You can't do the propellers, right?
Like, you don't
it's
do
a
it.
Jet.
Yes.
You could
yes.
do the propellers.
Jets.
You could do the propellers down in the islands.
Propeller.
Yeah. In the
propellers
islands,
are
yeah.
down in the islands when you're hopping around.
That's kitschy.
Beautiful.
That's kitschy.
Adorable. You're yes. a man of the people. Like,
there you go.
If I want to be man of the people, then I do the propellers. Yeah. You know what I mean? But
I would never stop
I
looking
want
at that propeller.
Nuclear.
So yeah, I don't know. I'm just looking into that shit. But you
see?
Realize how phony all this stuff is, man. Like anytime like a company IPOs, right? Like it
sure.
you know, hops on
the stock exchange.
The stock exchange, right? For the first time, like all the money's been made from that company before the IPO.
Yeah.
So like the whole idea of the stock exchange is, hey, we're going to raise money from the people, right? Because we need more capital to operate and those people will be invested in the success of the company.
Sure.
Now, the whole game is there's all these like series of funding.
Series
A, B, C, D, E, whatever. And it's just rich people going, okay, I'm going to get in on this. And then we all cash out at the IPO.
Yeah, that's the idea. They get in at a round of like, oh, it's valued at 10 million. I got in at 10 million. And then they do another round. It's now valued at 20. Fuck, I got to get in 30, 40. And then at IPOs. And then all the schlubs buy fucking stock, i.e. our parents.
We're
the schlubs.
Yes.
They buy stock. And then the guy who got in at 10 million is like, I just made 10 times my fucking
And return. Look, and you know how sometimes like a stock will drop, right? And
AYG then, stock tips coming
there
soon.
There it is. Hey, so you know a stock will drop and it like starts at $50 and then ends the day at 40.
Yeah.
And people are like, oh my God, what's going on here? They lost 10% or they lost whatever. What was that? They lost 20% of their evaluation. No, because that motherfucker got in at $8.
Yeah, of course.
He doesn't care that it ends at 40. No. You and I care.
Yeah.
Because we get rinsed.
He's golden.
Yes. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So then once you realize how this shit
he's
really works.
He's sitting back with a thing of scotch and a cigar being like, I don't care what you guys fucking close
at. So all the money's made before the money's made. Like,
are you diversifying? You got into stocks, Bitcoin
stuff?
I'm
financially illiterate, but I'm like
you
talking
somebody,
to people.
Yeah, okay.
I got some Bitcoin. I got rinsed in fucking Bitcoin. I just got
I love that
fucking
term. That's new money term. I got rinsed.
That's an English
that's
term.
Something a plumber says. Yeah. I got fleeced. I got rinsed in Bitcoin. I just stole that for sure.
I got rinsed in Enron and Mary Kay. They screwed me.
I got fucked in that, and I was chasing Akash. Akash was trying to get rich without me, and I was like,
he's
that's
been,
not going to happen.
Guy, Akash has been scheming. Me and him were talking about buying properties in Detroit like a decade ago.
Yeah. He's a little truffle, bro. He's a little truffle. He'll go after it. So I got kind of fucked in that. I don't know anything about like investing or anything like that. I really don't know what to do with money when I make it.
Sure.
I only know how to make money on myself. And I'm pretty good at that. But after that, the real motherfuckers take that money and they
and make
turn
wealth.
That.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So that's my biggest fear
that's
is that
nice.
Akash makes more money than me.
Yeah.
So that's my only motivating
force,
right?
Jesus Christ. Keep him in coach. Yeah.
That's the only. No. I want him to be in first class too.
Yeah.
But
just
don't own the
back.
Plane.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah
you know,
yeah,
that
yeah,
would drive
yeah,
me fucking
yeah,
insane.
Yeah, yeah.
So. Yeah,
I get
happen.
It.
Ah, this kid's competitive. No, I like it.
He's just shrewd when it comes to that stuff. He like fucked up smart maybe
guy.
A little bit with the Bitcoin, but like he's smart. He'll like look at these things and and I'm just not as
he's a mover and shaker when it comes to that.
Yeah, I'd rather outsource that, and maybe somebody will just take all my money and that happens. But I know that for me to get invested in that, like the time it would take, I just don't have the hours.
So that's why I asked you because you know when you get to a certain point, there's two roads you can go.
Yeah.
You could be the guy that handles everything, like he does everything, or the guy that has people to do it, and you're just kind of doing your thing.
You can't do
it. So you see it as like, would you want to have a driver eventually, not have to worry about that?
I mean, if it adds some level of efficiency in my day, like...
In New York, that doesn't make sense.
In New York, it doesn't make sense, right? You just hop an Uber. But, like...
I got a driver. I got a new driver every time I walk out of this fucking place.
Yeah. All
right. I don't care about that. Like, for me, it's just, like, a level of efficiency, right?
Okay.
It's like, if I had an hour to go to work and I could use that hour to do work...
To work,
then it makes more sense. And if that work provided more money than the driver costs, then it's a no-brainer, right? Mm-hmm. But,
That's rich guy thinking.
Yeah, he's never thought that ever. You're like, that's a no-brainer, and you're sitting there. That's never crossed his mind.
No, but that's good, right? If paying that guy helps you make more
money.
Don't
even start, because you're going to have 1,000 questions for me when you leave,
and I don't
feel like answering them.
I don't know.
What's a driver get paid anyway? I'm going to be fucking dealing with this shit.
I just want to zip around like Macaulay Culkin. Yeah. I don't give a shit.
Because I don't ever think about like that. Like, you know, for me, I understand like if you need to grow anything, you need people. And because you're not going to be able to make the best decision every single time.
Of course.
Like, at least with, you know, my team of guys, like, the best decision wins. Like, I don't have any ego about shit.
Sure.
Like, I have tons of ego, but
not about being the shot caller every time.
Exactly. The best idea wins.
Yeah. That's what we always say. If you can defend your idea, If like, you know, me and Toby sit around, we're like,
that's why we exclude Foley from all strategy meetings.
Typically, anytime he's involved in a strategy meeting, it ends up in name calling and almost fist fight.
I don't like getting into backing up ideas with facts and points and stuff like that.
But it's like, if you can defend your idea, if we don't have an idea, I'm like, you know, I don't just make something up about it. Well, we've never really figured this out, but let's try this and let's try this. It's like, well, you defend your idea. We both have sound logic. Let's try yours or try mine or whatever. Yeah, it's just
because I feel strongly about the best idea. I feel strongly about success. So like whatever's going to lead to that. And it could be the youngest guy on the team. Like we just picked up a new kid and he's 18 years old.
Damn.
And I mean, he's got
running the TikTok,
bro. Real talk.
Yeah, we just got a Bud Light. We call him Bud Light Intern. He's running the TikTok.
I love it.
Shout out to him.
Shout out to Bud Light Intern.
But no, you need them because they understand the culture. Like they understand how shit is changing. Like you need to. You're not going to make the best decision, and you need to hire people that make great decisions, and you need to empower those decisions.
Sure, of course.
You know, like it's very easy for me to micromanage, like stand over people's shoulders and do all that kind of shit, and that's annoying. But I'm also a perfectionist. But I gotta hire the people where I could go, oh wow, they're more of a perfectionist than me.
Yeah,
surround yourself with greatness. Yeah.
You know what, Schulz? That was the best decision Kippy made, was hiring me.
It was great. It absolutely was.
T-Bone's fantastic. T-Bone, I'm like, dude.
We would have hired T-Bone if it was a little bit different timing.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Well, now
he does have
him.
A business card, and I really want you to take a look at it.
If you I sent that right as the pandemic hit. Schulz is like, hey, come back in 6 months.
Yeah.
If you can afford to pay him more than minimum wage, he's yours.
All right.
Because he's only getting $8.15 an hour here.
No, but you guys are building something. This is beautiful.
Thank you, buddy.
I love it.
Grilled you. We beat you up and up. We want to ask you a couple questions from Patreon before we get you out of here. We know you got to make a move.
No, I got a couple. Are you TSA pre-checked?
Yeah.
Okay.
And clear.
The whole team?
Yeah. Except Mark won't get fucking pre-checked, this idiot.
He doesn't want to give up his fingerprints or whatever.
It's probably that.
Yeah, it's
really?
Like that.
It's
yeah.
probably that. But he's clear. And I think clear has it.
Clear works. It's one level less though, right?
I give my butthole prints if I don't have to take my shoes off.
Yeah, I know.
Well, he can't get them back on.
Yeah,
that's the
pain
issue.
In the ass. I'm jamming up the line. People are yelling at me.
I mean, he was like, I don't know if I can get these on. I'm like, I'm not helping you put your shoes on.
When you're pre-checked, you have to take your shoes off?
I don't think so.
Probably give you a golf cart, roll right through. That's what I'm
saying. You got to get clear and TSA pre. That's the quickest one.
Yeah.
Let's
I want to get global. I mean, we can do it.
Yeah.
I want to get global, the global passport.
Yeah, I got
where
that.
You can just cook through.
Yeah.
You can cook through other countries.
Well, if you do global, you can only cook through the countries that accept global.
Yeah. But that's like
don't.
Most of the EU, though.
I think the
whole EU accepts global.
But if you get global, you get TSA pre.
Yeah. That's the Cadillac or the fake Porsche.
But then
you
just got to go to fucking JFK and like spend a few.
I heard they do it in Midtown now, though.
I
heard there's a thing in Midtown. I could be wrong, but I think they were like, we just open up in Midtown. Everybody. It's like $89 or $200 or something like that.
100%
worth it. Yeah, we can do that. Do you have a plan? Are you going bald?
I've been on keeps for a decade longer.
Killer. Okay.
I was early adopter, like when it was Fight Club. Like when you would mention it and then someone would look at you and they'd be like, oh, yeah, I'm on it. But we called it Propecia at the time.
Yeah.
Vitamin P.
Finasteride.
Vitamin P. But you got to get on it. I mean, are you on it now?
I've been on it for a couple of years. I've stopped. Yeah. I've it stopped balding. It's just kind of maintaining this.
Okay,
but
that's what you have to accept. You just gotta accept this is what I got.
Oh yeah, for sure.
But it's gonna hold it there.
I've been on it for years. Yeah. It's holding.
But 100%. Like you gotta. But it's amazing. Like when you get older, it's fucking crippling, man. Sometimes like we did these shows in Atlanta, and like the way that the light
it hits, and when it gets thin, it gets tough.
But no, but it was weird. It's like my hair's
that happens to everybody though. If your hair's thin, the footlights
are
going to catch
you. No, but this was specifically bad, and I think it was like the way I did it or some shit like that, and the light, it was like the perfect mixture, I had a fucking egg in the middle of my head.
Looked like
and
Stanley
I posted
Tucci
clips
up there.
And stuff like that, and it's just like embarrassing, because I'll be on this angle, a hero look fine, and this one, there's just this giant gap on top of my head. Oh my God. So yeah, you're a little bit more hyper aware of it, but I would get that surgery in a
second. Would you do plugs? You would do plugs? Well, you got the cash to pay
really?
For the good surgery.
Yeah, you go to Turkey if you don't have the cash.
Yeah, you go to Turkey, fly to
and then
Turkey.
You get a trip to Turkey. Like
that's weird. Me and a couple other comedians were talking about just doing it for content, like five of us flying over to Turkey to
who,
get
Slovic? You were talking to
yeah,
Slovic?
It was Robbie.
Yeah. What, getting cheap
just
plugs
all getting
done?
Cheap plugs in Turkey? Maybe do a show?
My hair guy.
Everybody's got a straight
my hair. The guy who cuts my hair, Alex, is not different Alex, but he's
like a
be
guy
fucked up if you were making Alex Media
right?
cut
Imagine.
Your hair.
One second,
everything
cutting the house, or you go to the place.
That was my follow up question.
What?
Does he come to you, or you go to him?
He would during the pandemic. He would come.
Okay.
To the studio, I would get a cut. The studio.
But now you go. You go to his shop, or what's the play?
It depends. Whatever works more, like timing wise.
Okay.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah, yeah. Like I don't mind if I can do it within time, but if I like have to do it and then I have podcast that day, another shit we got to get
done.
He'll
say, hey, can you come over and go?
He'll pull up. He's the best. But he told me, he's like, listen, all the athletes and shit in Europe, mm-hmm. they just go to Turkey to do it.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
it's
yeah.
not like you're going to Tijuana to get your fucking
Turkey. Yeah, yeah, you're going to Turkey. No, Turkey's yeah. proud. Turkey's the place to go, yeah.
Yeah, they're legit at it. They're mm-hmm. good. And these people know hair.
Yeah, yeah. Like, I got a lot of it.
Everybody there has hair, so imagine yeah. you didn't have it.
Yeah.
You would want it fixed. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. They know what they're doing.
Yeah, that's like, balding's a choice. You should get that shit if you want it.
I just can't afford the goods. I don't mind telling people. It was the same thing of like fake Porsche. I wouldn't mind being like, yo, I for sure have plugs. I paid 30, 40 grand for it.
I got a guy in Canal Street that'll hook you
yeah,
up.
No, of course. Yeah. I just don't. My biggest fear was getting them at the rate I can afford and then looking bad and then being like, oh, now I look like a fucking asshole. I don't want to look like an asshole. I don't mind people knowingly I got plugs. I would do it for content. I put it on the fucking Patreon.
It'd be great. Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, if we could. I mean, I want it done right, though. That's my only thing.
Just get it tattooed.
Yeah, the Dominicans do that in my neighborhood. They just tattoo the line back on their head. It's like, buddy, I can see that shit. I don't know who you think you're fooling.
It's good.
All right, we got two from the Patreon here. As you guys know, when you join the Patreon, we will ask your garbage question on air. It's just the best way to do it. This is from Miriam. Are you currently living with one or more missing teeth?
No, I don't do that.
Your teeth got good teeth?
I don't do the missing teeth.
You never had missing teeth, right?
No. And that you got? Do you have missing teeth?
I mean,
how many?
Enough.
How many?
Enough.
Let me see.
You tell me.
They're over here.
Give me a guess.
I'm going to pay to have whatever teeth you want fixed. I mean that sincerely.
They're going to be, yeah.
I want Gary Busey's all around.
No, I'm not going to do the whole thing. I'll have those fixed 100%. I told my mom, I was like.
She missing teeth?
Yeah, my mom's.
That's been, old country.
She's
stuff.
Scottish,
yeah.
bro. Like
oh, did you do that? Did you hook her up?
Yeah, I bought her teeth. But
you
like,
did?
Yeah.
Oh, that's fucking awesome.
They already rotted out though.
My dad is. You know, my dad's basically got like Alzheimer's, right? So like, his mind is gone. So he doesn't care about like if he has a tooth gone. Like,
sure.
He's yeah. never really cared about these things. But I told him like, when I get married, you guys got to have the teeth. And it's sure. a weird thing that I care
what,
about.
What, for the
stupid.
Pictures and shit?
No, but it looks like I'm not taking care of my parents.
Ah.
I can't be
no, it makes sense.
Being successful. And then my dad's missing a fucking tooth, and I'm this douchebag that like is not taking care of their parents. So
right.
they don't want anything. They don't want for a single fucking thing, and it drives me crazy because I want to get them.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I can't convince my parents to let me pick up a check.
Really?
Just
pay
but
for it.
You want to do it.
Yeah, but you got to pay for
it. I do. I pull them. Of course I do.
I never go. I never reach. They got cash. It's fine.
Really?
I never reach.
Oh, you got some animosity or something.
Yeah.
You got some resentment. That's different. That's specific.
He's still the bozo in the family. I'm starting to make the come up a little bit in the Foley family tree.
Now you got to take care of. You got to pay the bill.
They would never let me though. They would
you
never.
You give the card. I always get you drop the card.
Also, this is like the first week I could ever do it. By the
you
way,
walk over to the waiter.
Like it's not like I've ever been confident enough. Like just after the 1st of July, where we like, I can pick up a check.
It's actually this weekend coming up. It was supposed to be last month, or going into Memorial Day, we were supposed to be flush. And a couple of things
got
held up.
We got hemmed up a couple of advertisers, yeah.
Oh, really?
Well, we're all good. Everything got straight. Everything got sorted out, but we thought last
ruined
month
ruined the weekend, though.
Yeah, we really? Were
going
into Memorial
I was
Memorial
running my
Day.
Mouth up until Monday.
Yeah. We were like, we're going into Memorial Day fucking flush. I look over. I almost had to borrow $200 off T-Bone.
I hit my apartment for 3 days. That's what happened.
I'm going to fix your teeth.
I'm missing
three. Oh, yeah, back to that.
I will put them in your face.
No.
I mean this.
I'm going to get them.
No, I'll do it. And then you pay me back.
No, I'm not going into you. What are you, nuts?
You're going to be his new driver.
You're not really gonna,
paying off that
You're not really going to pay me back. I'm just saying that so you don't feel like a loser to the people listening. But the point is, I think you need those teeth. Teeth are very important.
Cut me a check. Make it out the cash.
I'm getting them done in Turkey.
I'll do some...
Schulz, we just got him on a diet, man. He doesn't need the teeth.
Yeah, he's going to make him a more efficient eater.
Your teeth
eater.
Are trying to help you lose weight.
Like, Jesus
I'm
Christ.
I'm out of here.
They're jumping ship. This fucking guy's breaking our stones over here.
Liquids only. No,
come
but
on, he needs us.
For real, man, you can't be missing teeth, dude. It is a big it's a big thing, bro.
I take good care of my teeth other than them. All right.
Other than the ones that left.
I took care of all my kids. Yeah. That's what you
except the three that died on me.
Except for the three that moved out.
That one that drowned in the pool had it coming.
No, but you know what's weird is I'm missing two over here, but I have a wisdom teeth coming in back here, so it's good for the pressure. So they can move a little bit.
See,
oh and then when man, the time
that is dirt bag when, dentistry.
When
right
the time's there. Right, I'm gonna get implants. I'm gonna get veneers. I'm gonna get nice ones.
Oh, everybody's.
I appreciate the offer. I love it. Thank you.
I am gonna buy you those teeth.
Take a super soaker. How about that?
But maybe you can just get some fill-ins for the time being.
Nah, yeah, I don't
get
like
some
the
temps.
Fill-ins.
Get the ones on like a fucking retainer or something.
Yeah, it's like a wire hooks the other teeth.
I hate that stuff. I had braces the whole nine yards. I had braces and all that
stuff.
But
that's not braces. This is just teeth.
Yeah, I can't do it. Because I'll bite it, it'll break off.
You're trying to understand chaos theory right now. His logic makes zero sense to anybody outside Foleyville. It doesn't make sense outside of his brain.
I want to buy you teeth.
I appreciate it.
He won't let me.
No.
No.
No. No.
I buy teeth? No. Come on.
It's important, guys.
If it
you
was
guys talk for a living. You smile for a living.
If it, you can't
people
see
are buying into you.
My teeth, you can't even see.
You can't do veneers.
They're not there.
You can't do veneers.
Why can't I do veneers?
Can't do veneers. It's not you.
Sure it is. It's going to be. I'm going to have big choppers. Mm-hmm. Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the Are You Garbage Podcast.
Oh, God.
Thank you.
No,
you're
I sweet. Think you got to have your own teeth, man.
I'm going to get them.
Let's just fill those in.
What do you mean? You can't fill them in. There's nothing there.
I'm saying we put a little...
throw a couple of fucking Jonskis in
what
there.
What are you?
Yeah.
Go to Home Depot, get some Quick Crete. Hook this fat bastard up real quick.
I think we should do it.
I'm totally in. Why not? Let them... Well, come on.
Dual share content.
Yeah, there we go.
All on yours.
Crossover promote, yeah. Foley wants to... That's what Schulz needs, to redo a fat guy's teeth on his Patreon.
Come on, let's do it. I
brought
think
to you
be
by
funny.
Queen Smiles.
Oh, yeah, we get a sponsor for it.
Yeah,
oh,
Smile Cafe. Yeah.
I think that'd be great. But it also is
if
important.
If they were in the front, yeah.
Teeth are important, bro.
I floss and brush every day. My mom worked at a dentist office. We're ingrained in that stuff.
But you still lost three of them. So I got don't, with, I her got, working at a dentist office doesn't help.
Because I got hit in the face with a lacrosse ball, and they just went bad over the next couple of years.
Is that
true? It's a story I tell people.
Yeah, no. I was friends with you.
I got
when
a
you
couple,
got,
couple shoddy root canals.
Yeah. I was friends with you. You got dentist work done in a garage that one time.
No, it wasn't a garage. My mom's friend
it was who's a carport.
My mom's friend, who's an oral surgeon, used to park his motorcycle in her garage. Okay. That's what it was. Yeah. They were friends.
I knew there was a. Anytime there's a garage fucking in a dentistry transaction, it's a tough look. All right?
I can't believe you won't let me buy you those teeth.
No, you're the best, man. I wouldn't have you do that. Thank you.
Is it because you don't want me to spend the money or
you're
you just don't want to do it?
You're never going
to
get it. I love the fact that,
I'm curious. Yeah.
I wouldn't impose on you on that. What do you mean?
It's not imposition.
I offered. One, I don't need them.
Got a $40,000 watch. He can afford a couple of molars.
Let me borrow the Rolex a couple times a month. No, we're good. We're doing good. I'm going to get my own.
There you go.
But that's what I want.
He can afford teeth in a couple of... You can probably afford teeth now. You can finance.
I can afford teeth now, yeah.
His credit limit just got raised.
Put that on your thumb.
That's it.
Before we go, we have a question you got to ask him.
Yeah.
The wedding.
Oh! By the way...
You're going to the wedding.
We're
going to
be hobnobbing at the same social function coming up
very
soon.
I can't wait. I thought about bringing it up, and then I was like...
Well,
you're not getting me teeth in at the wedding. You're pulling me over to a crowd. Foley, show him the teeth that guy
And they're signed by... It says A. Schulz on it.
You pull a Billy Bats. Yeah, Foley, go home and get your incisors, huh? You're very sweet. I love you.
Love you, bro.
So we had Casey in to talk about the wedding.
I should have offered off the pot.
No, it's great.
I still wouldn't have
taken
it.
You still wouldn't have taken it?
No. All right. You're not buying me teeth. I'll buy you teeth.
That's what it is. It's an ego thing.
Yeah.
No.
Off the pot, it would have worked.
You're so sweet.
No, it wouldn't have.
Really? No, yeah. If I had no teeth in the front.
I would pay for it if I had no teeth in the front. All right?
Okay, or have the rest of them removed.
Go with the wedding. Go with the wedding.
Yes. So a big thing we ask everybody now since the last time we've done it is what do they typically give at a wedding? And obviously that depends on...
Indians or just normal...
Normal, like a normal wedding.
Normal people.
You're going...
Where'd that come from?
He's got two weddings coming up.
He's got Akash's wedding tomorrow.
Yeah.
So what are you... We're already on record.
Yeah.
Saying what we're going to give.
Okay.
What do you think...
Hang on. It might be more interesting.
Yeah.
I want to know what you're going to do, Akash, and what you're going to do, KCB. You write it down on that piece of paper. If you don't want us to say it publicly, we won't.
No, no. I mean,
we just talked about the watch.
Yeah, we can talk about it.
Yeah.
What do I do, Akash?
Still write it down, though.
So we got Akash.
Write it down and slide it across the table.
Like a rich guy.
Now, so we got Akash.
And are you even a cash guy at a wedding? You couldn't maybe. We
you could be a good gift guy.
Assuming, yeah,
too.
You could be just a good gift guy.
But this is an Indian wedding.
They don't do cash. They do a gift?
No, they do cash.
They just do nice. Cash.
And the increment has to have a one at the end. Ooh. So you don't leave $100, you leave $101.
Really?
Yeah, the zero is bad luck or something like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
I bet you that wedding's going to be fantastic.
Yeah, we're going to have some fun.
He's throwing down.
We're going to have some fun. But
I can't wait for Casey Beats.
But yeah, we got.
I was on the bubble for that one.
What? Oh yeah.
tough break, Baldy.
I'm trying to
see you in Turkey.
They didn't like his 5 minute tape.
I'm reworking some stuff. They told me to try again next year.
What do I get, Akash? I don't know. We got Akash this like tray from Hermes. You know,
ooh,
Hermes.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Now we got him the tray from Hermes. Mm-hmm. Because my girl thought that would help her get a bag.
At their wedding?
No, for herself.
Oh, from Hermes.
Yeah, yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Wait,
how would
that help her?
With these types of stores, like, you need to show, like, a history of buying stuff. It's a mm-hmm. whole racket.
What?
Yeah, yeah. You can't just walk in and get a bag. It's like a watch, I'm telling you. That's why these girls are so
obsessed. They control the fucking...
It's like sneakers
They control the supply.
So
if they don't know you, they're not going to give you the nice bag.
Even if they know you maybe you didn't spend enough there. Even if they know you spent enough, they're like, we don't want that type of person wearing a bag.
Holy shit, I had no idea.
It's like, not only is it too expensive to purchase, it's you're not allowed to purchase it.
Yeah.
They have to decide if you purchase it.
Now I know where the guy at DXL is always following me around the store.
What is DXL?
Fat guy store.
Ah, okay.
Double, I don't know.
Anyway,
something XL.
So, I don't know. And then I'll give him some cash. So I think that was like $500 or something like that. And then I'll give him some cash. But that's my guy. Like,
I
feel like if I give him less than $1,000, that I'm kind of being a piece of shit.
Sure. Yeah.
Right.
I agree. Yeah. I mean,
the other
that's
thing
a
with
nice
this
number.
No, but the other thing with
you
this
didn't
is
write
like,
it down, but it's still a nice number.
We're also spending a lot of money to go to this fucking wedding.
Yeah.
So that's. I think that should be calculated into the
deal. Of course. This always goes into it.
Schulz is old school as they get.
It's two nights. It's a rental car. Right? It's a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Dude, you're everybody's uncle. I love it.
I don't know. It's a lot.
They got no parking.
$2,000 a minute is wedding for already.
Really? Really? I'm trying to think. Yeah, we'll probably end up spending that. Yeah. Isn't that crazy? I don't know. What do you guys think?
I like what you said.
Yeah, a grand to
nice.
Akash. That's your fucking.
It's got to be a grand.
You've been in the trenches.
Come on, it's
I mean,
gotta
that
be.
Goes back to Lantern Day.
Yes,
like you guys
my
are
best friend.
Of course,
man.
You guys trenches.
You got little kids out there looking up to you. It's got to be a G.
You guys created a huge thing. It's you know. Yeah,
it's got to be at least a grand.
A jihad. Jihad.
Yeah. I think so. A jihad. Okay, why? What are you guys in for?
Well,
28
we're talking about Casey and Robbie's.
Oh no, Casey and Robbie's.
That's a little, obviously there's more distance, you're not as tight, I mean obviously you're tight with
Robbie. It's got to be at least five.
Yeah.
Got to be at least five.
It's all making sense.
Yeah.
I think, right?
Minimum.
That's,
for you, minimum five.
Minimum.
I think that's the.
It might be a G.
Wow.
But that
diminishes Akash's
gift. It does.
No.
They're giving these two bums a G?
Nah, but like Akash and I like. A wedding gift, like we've been.
You're closer than
that's,
that.
It means like
it's like me giving like this is what it is. It's like it's me giving somebody that I make money with $1,000.
It doesn't
like,
make any
what
sense.
Is
yeah,
it,
yeah.
Like,
I would be like I wouldn't expect a gift from. It's just like I don't.
Akash
it doesn't mean anything.
Paid
to me.
For the hotel for my parents, and I'm like, bro, don't do that. And he's just like, buddy, like you're gonna
fuck?
Do something.
Yeah.
It's
all cyclical,
communal
yeah,
money.
Yeah,
you know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah.
So, but I feel like I have to do it just out of principle. But like with Robbie and Casey, yeah, I don't know. It's between 500 and G. I got nothing for Mark for his wedding.
Wow.
Yeah.
Why?
Not even a card? Nothing?
Because we started doing the fucking Netflix special the day after his, the Monday after his wedding. He got married on Saturday. And I told him, I go, listen, we start Monday. And this is going to kill us.
Mm-hmm.
And I need you on deck Monday. Okay, you do your fucking, what is it called? Honeymoon some other time.
Sure.
Okay?
Cutthroat businessman.
24 years old, you get to co-create a Netflix special. You don't get to take fucking honeymoons all the time, right? Like, you take a honeymoon later. I'd like to get married, too.
Was this in the speech at the wedding reception? Hold on a second. I want to say
I'll
something.
See you Monday. And then this guy, I call him on a Sunday. I'm like, are you on your way? Because I had a feeling. And he's like, dude, my parents got us this house on the beach or something like that. I'm like, you motherfucker.
Yikes.
And, so I didn't get him a wedding gift, but I paid him for that week.
That's fair enough.
I feel like it's
fair.
All right.
You know,
I'll give you that.
You get a paid vacation.
Yeah.
But I was so fucking, and I was gonna give him something nice too.
Yeah.
It was gonna be nice.
Damn. Write it down.
Because he's a kid and it means more. Like if I give Akash $2,000, it doesn't change his fucking life.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But if you give a kid a big check.
Him
and his fiance or his wife go
starting a life.
It means more.
Yeah,
it's more exciting.
Sure.
Uncle Schulze.
Yeah,
that's nice.
I like that.
You have no idea how happy that makes me to hear those answers. I know I can't explain it. Come out of your mouth.
Why?
Because for all we know, you could have been like, I'm not really a cash guy. I like to give a bowl or
a blender. Like
something
we
like
gave a bowl, kind of.
Yeah, but Airman.
But I mean, in general,
you didn't get it at a fucking Target.
And you said,
you know what I mean? Come on,
right?
What the fuck
numbers
are we talking about, Schulze.
Right numbers out of the gate, 1,500. That's why we love you.
I feel
buddy.
Like it's got to be that.
That's
right?
Top notch, yeah.
Be.
That's yeah. We went on record as 100 and 150. So
one with the one at the end, with the one at the end, right? 101, 151.
Yeah.
And I think it's got to be round numbers. I think it's got to be like 201.
One.
So who's dropping the 150?
No, we're joking.
150.
Wait,
what?
No, I was kidding. For Casey and Robbie's, we said joking. I mean, I said I have to beat him. He said he's doing three, so I said I'm doing four.
Really? That's big. I think that's
big. Make a couple of bucks.
And you're there for
something?
A few days or what?
There for a few days.
Happy to be there.
Bought a new suit for this. Bought new shoes for this.
Getting a new
suit
for this.
Really? Are you doing Indian outfits?
We're not going to Akash's.
He didn't invite y'all?
No, that's why I said we're on
the
bubble.
Bubble.
For that.
I wouldn't expect that.
Fuck, dude.
I might rock one of Casey and Robbie's just to shake
what
things
up. What if
Akash
though? Rides out on Foley? What if we.
We'll spray paint you gray.
What if we have.
As long as I can hit the buffet, I would actually. I'd be okay with that.
Really
get my hand
people.
In a couple
so wait,
samosas.
So
I'm
that,
happy.
So how did that work out? Because you guys are close.
Me and Akash are tight.
You can't get mad at stuff like that, especially
like that.
These days,
look,
man.
As you get
anybody,
older,
anybody that bitches about.
Oh
that,
yeah, yeah. No, I don't.
Can't expect.
Yeah,
anything.
That's nothing. He was like, dude, if it's in India, you can fucking come if you want, because that's just like whoever wants to fly the fuck out. I was like, yo, I'll go to India for sure.
Yeah.
But then he was like, it's in. You know, I don't know.
How do you handle that conversation? That's my biggest fear.
To me.
Yeah,
I didn't. First of all, I didn't think I was ever going to be invited.
Oh, so that was the next.
And then he was just So then he was just like, "Yo," because he had mentioned the India thing because when we worked together in Philly, and then he was like, "I don't think." He's like, "Now everything's moving. I don't know the limits." I'm like, "Yeah, I don't. You know, I didn't expect it to begin with."
Don't have any anxiety about that. That would bum me out if I knew you were worried about that. Listen, the position
you're
in.
That's my biggest fear.
Come on,
dude.
Listen. What? Anybody who cares, fuck them.
Well,
nobody should, unless it's like your mom or something like that.
I guess,
cutting
yeah.
Cutting her out.
No,
but
I would never do that.
Of course.
Like, my girl was, like, her father, we're going to get married in December, right? So, like, we're going through all, the wedding planning stuff now. And, like, her father wanted to throw, like, a dinner the night before for, like, the close family.
Sure.
And nice. I'm like, don't do that to me. I was like, don't do that. Like, because I don't want to have to
That's
tell,
a rehearsal dinner.
Yeah, but I don't have to tell certain friends they're not as close.
Well, rehearsal dinners should be limited to the people in the wedding party.
Sure.
That's it.
But we don't have a wedding party. So then it just becomes family friends. And, like, I have friends that are closer than family. You know what I mean? Like, my friend group is closer than my cousins. Like, I have very few cousins coming to the wedding. I might have, like, one or something like that. So I can't really divide things like that. Usually family makes it easy. You're just like, okay, only family's here. And then your boys go, oh, I get it, whatever. But we're closer. So it's just a tricky. What?
It's tough.
What? Why are you guys looking?
It's dicey.
He didn't come to mind.
Oh, yeah. I wouldn't make that connection.
Oh, wow. Really? I thought he was
you
like,
were
yes,
invited I'm, to.
It's.
I was trying to figure out in my head where I'm falling in the line with what Schulze is saying.
Fuck. I thought, how did you not? But I mean, you've been fucking throwing it in my face for the past 18 months.
I was sitting
months.
There smiling at you like a dog. Just like,
Hold on. You didn't invite him?
It's way more complicated than that.
Is it?
Yes, it is. So
yeah, he's annoying.
Yeah, I mean, can't have a toothless guy at my fucking wedding.
Son, that's how I feel.
Oh, is that what you?
He's trying to make you presentable for his wedding.
all for me. This is all.
Listen, I got to get my mom, my dad teeth, and the fat guy.
Hey, Schulz, a new suit. Thanks, buddy. And the haircut. Holy cow. Where are we going?
No, I had a. We had a very small wedding. It was just family and my family.
300 people.
300 people.
No, how no. Many? It was like she, because my family's huge.
What's the number?
That came to the wedding?
Yeah.
40.
See, that's something like, I feel like 40, like I feel like under 100.
And 15 of those were from, 15 to 20 of those were from her. So I just matched, because my family's huge.
Yeah.
So it was like, My cousins who were like my brothers, growing up, didn't get invited, and they're fucking mad at me because I'm like, then the pandemic hits. So we were supposed to have a huge party afterwards, like a proper wedding celebration, and then that just didn't happen.
That's the tricky thing. Pandemic fucked a lot of people with that. But I feel like once you've done a wedding, you don't take it personal.
Not at all, dude. Because there's a list.
Nobody should for any. That's ridiculous.
But if you haven't done one yet, you do personalize it. Like people who haven't done a wedding, I'm sure I'm guilty of this. You know, if you don't get a plus one, you're like,
oh, what the fuck?
I never realized that one person is so valuable. You know what I mean?
Oh.
Hold on. I got to shit because I'm hungover, but I'll be right back.
Well, let's just wrap it up.
Yeah, we'll wrap it up.
Just wrap up right now.
I have to shit my pants right now.
Jesus Christ.
Hold on. Where's the bathroom? Do I need a key?
I know there's commercial bills.
It's right there. On the Pelican. All right. Well, listen. We thank you for coming in.
Of course.
Appreciate it.
We love you.
Thank you. I love you guys.
Anything you want the folks out there to know?
That they might not know
that
already.
They might not?
Come check out the tour. Mm-hmm. Man, the tour is going to be fun.
Pretty cool.
Guy's a killer on stage, too, by the way.
Pretty good.
Cool.
What a convo. What an episode. Kippy, what do you got for him?
As always, please make sure you rate, view, subscribe, iTunes, YouTube, Patreon, the whole nine. Check us out. We appreciate all the support.
Beautiful. Gang, we love you. See you next week. Peace.
Peace.